Hello and welcome back. Today I have a very exciting remodel to show you. This was one I was very nervous about. It's the party house. I've redone the kids' party house before, but I've never done just the party house. And to be honest with you, I had never bought it or put it in my town or redone it. So when Nancy asked me to do this and I took a really hard look at it, it made me a little nervous. Not only because of the flat front, but just the rooms in general. So when I come back, I'm going to show you how I took this house that you're looking at right here and turned it into this. So I gave you a little glimpse of the after, but right now we're going to actually go through the before, and then I'm going to take you on a tour of what it looks like all through the house after I got finished. This house to me is a little bit crazy. I know it's supposed to be a party house, but when I think of a party house, I think of a sophisticated place where whether it be grown-ups or younger adults would party and have nice items and all of that. I get the kids party thing and there's a separate house for the kids parties, but for the adult party house, I mean, really, this is kind of a mess. And I hate to say that, but I mean, look at it. You know, I kind of get the DJ equipment, the lighting and all of that, but I think it's a little bit much. And being a grown up, if I were going to be invited to a party, this is honestly the last thing I would expect to walk into. I don't know. And then there's a little apartment type home on the top of it, which honestly isn't that bad. I mean, that's actually pretty nice if you think about it. It's got some nice furnishings in it. Not really my taste, but since I'm going to do a remodel, obviously I'm taking everything out, and you'll see me do that here in a second. I took it all out. And if you're new here, you may not know, when I do these remodels, I don't change the walls. So that made it a little bit challenging. But I have to say, when you see the after, you may agree with me when I make the statement that this is possibly the biggest change I've ever seen in any of my remodels. So when I come back, you're going to see what it looks like now. Remember this? There's the before, and here is the after. Quite a big difference just on the exterior, right? So since I don't change the walls, but the exterior was so flat on the front, I wanted to give it a little something extra. So what I did was I actually added a third floor, but I didn't want to change any of the walls underneath. So I made most of the roof a balcony and added these rooms, if you want to call them that, on the upstairs on the third floor, and just walled them in with windows and made them skylights that look down into the rooms. That gave the front less of a flat appearance. Yes, it's still flat, but it totally distracts the eye from that bland, flat brown appearance that it had before, and it gives the home an entirely different look. And remember the big party room downstairs? I wasn't sure what to do with it. Look at it now. It is a huge dream garage. So this house I have created for a fun-loving young couple. They have no children and they love to entertain. So keep that in mind as you're looking at this house. This would be a dream garage for both my husband and myself. I would love to have this pool table, the jukebox down there, an area where he could work on the car. Of course, there are the trash bins. And there's also an area over here where you can kind of peek through the glass to see the entryway. There is a separate entryway for the home, but you can see it through the garage. There's a drone there, a workbench, and a freezer. Pretty much anything you could think of that you would need in there. And over here to the left, there is a full bath. There is a full bath upstairs for the house itself, but I wanted to put one down here because I figured if they're working in the garage or playing pool, it would be handy to have one down here, as well as if they're out here in this area where the hot tub is. So I've put a stereo out here, some seating, a beautiful little orange flower, and I've given the panels there for privacy, and then there's the hot tub. So that's why I wanted to have a full bath on this level as well, in case guests are using that area. So this is the garage from the back angle. I really like how it's laid out. I'm so glad that I thought to just make this that huge garage area, and I've also used one of those wider type black patio doors instead of a garage door, and the car does fit through there because I wanted it to match all of those black windows. This is the actual entry to the home, and the first thing you're going to see is the bar area where I've actually put the bar here and then just a little bar that wraps around that you can sit at and have drinks. And I figured this would be a good location for that, because that way if people are downstairs playing pool or if they're upstairs, it would kind of be a central location and you could just head upstairs with your drinks if you needed to. So let's pop upstairs here and let's take a look, because this is my favorite part of the build here. Even though I love the garage a lot, I love this great room. You remember what it looked like before? It was very plain. Now it's not. It's neutral, but it's not plain. So I wanted to give them a smaller galley kitchen and leave the rest of the room open for entertainment. I've put one of the newer wine racks on the wall, along with the recipe book and the knives, a coffee maker, a microwave, and I've lined the sink area up with the staircase there because I just thought everything would flow a lot better. And I really like how that kitchen is tucked back in that side of the room. We have the new gold mirror over there. And yes, I've kept a neutral tone in the room, but I wanted to do that because I did not want it to look cluttered, because if you're going to entertain a lot, the last thing you want is a lot of clutter. So I wanted to give them a place where they could sit down and use the home theater. And, you know, if they're home by themselves and they're not entertaining, of course, they can just sit there and read a book. Here we have the dining area. It does seat 8 people, which I think is plenty. I've used the new little planter there on the table and those nice, I think they're from the chalet, the hanging light fixtures. And I think it all just flows together so well, the whole room from the dining area, the living room to the kitchen. And that's exactly the idea that I had in my head, and I'm glad it played out that way. Sometimes it doesn't do that, but this time I feel like it did. In here we have the laundry room, just a simple laundry room. Now the floor, if you guys could tell me in the comments, I don't have this floor in my inventory. Am I missing something, or was this just in this house? I have no idea, but I would really, really like to know, because I think it's beautiful. Back through here is still the master bedroom. I just took everything out and redecorated it. And I've used that black and gold furniture, which I really, really love. And I've put some perfumes there, just a Japanese decoration on the dresser. And I've used one of the newer TVs. And I wanted to leave this side of the room open. And I like how the room turned out, lots of contrast. And then there are 2 doors in here. One goes to the master closet, where I put a hamper and a mirror, and then just your regular closet units there. And then the other door in the master bedroom leads to the master bath. So I'm gonna show you when I do the furniture placement, how I do the shower. Some of you probably already have it figured out, but I'll take it apart and show it to you, because I had a couple of comments asking me how I did that, and it is not glitched, it just does it. So I'll show you here in just a second how I did that. But for a small bathroom, I think it's really a pretty bathroom, and it, you know, it's the nice rose gold, and I love that little rose gold fixture there with the picture frame and the light. I didn't even realize I had that in my inventory. I must have gotten that out of an architect home as well. So that's an overview here of the apartment level, I guess the living level of the home. And then I wanted to show you what I did with the roof here. So again, I made it mostly a balcony, and then I put, that's a square room, I think 4x4. And then I did a, I wanna say 6x6 there. And I think this one's a 3x3. I'll have to check the measurements just for the skylights. That way, again, it doesn't look as flat on the front. It kind of distracts the eye from that big flat front that it has. And right here, you'll see the furniture placement. So we have the garage here, where I just have everything. Again, I really love that garage. I wish I could put that large of a garage in all my other builds, but it's just kind of not, I don't know, it's not practical, if you know what I mean. And then we have the entryway over there. Zoom in. And I'm going to start trying to zoom in a little bit better, because I think some of you want to see up close where I've put even the, like, the little decorations and things. And I also wanted to note, while we're looking at the furniture, I have started to upload in a better quality. I hope I have that issue fixed, but from where I live in the middle of a forest, literally. I have a very bad connection, so it can take hours to upload videos in high quality, if they ever do. But I think I may have the situation figured out, and hopefully, I think starting 3 videos back, I started on a higher quality. I hope you can see everything a little bit better. Let me know if that's true. So while we're here, I'm going to show you how I did the shower. So I'm just going to disassemble it. So what you do is you just take one of the chalet showers and you just put it where the glass is sort of, you know, against the wall. That's very, there's no glitch involved. You just put it to where the glass is against the wall. You just turn it. Then you just take one of the screens and just pop it in there. Now the screen you cannot put against a wall, but as long as it's out in the open there, it will go against the shower. And we don't need to do the grid because it was a remodel and I didn't change the walls, but I'm going to show you what it looks like at night. I think it looks beautiful lit up, especially with the skylights because you can see into all of those beautiful rooms there. I just think it looks gorgeous. I'm so pleased with it. So Nancy, thank you so much for requesting this. This is definitely one of those remodels that I would have never done. I honestly even forgot we had the home. And I do remember when we first got it, I didn't like it at all. And I thought, I will never build this house in my town. But I'm so glad you requested it because again, I had so much fun doing this remodel. And all of you, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you've enjoyed this, please give me a like. It really means a lot. I hope everyone's doing well. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in my next video.